In this video, I'm going to show you how to add sheets from selected cells and then how to hyperlink those cells to the newly created sheets. So I'll show you how it works first of all. So I have a list of students here, and then this would be my list of students here, and then I also have a list of their mark breakdown, and this is what their mark breakdown would look like. Now I'd like to create a sheet for every student with this mark breakdown copied onto the new sheet, and I'd like the students, the names, to be on the sheet so I know where they are. Finally, I would like to be able to hyperlink the names to these sheets. Let's add a student's name to the list. So let's type in Joe, and we'll call it black. Okay, now I select that cell. I click the Add button to access my macro. And there I have Joe Black, and it's hyperlinked to the sheet. So I click on Joe Black, and I instantly go to the Joe Black sheet. So now I'll show you how I did it. So here we have my code. Now, so my sub's name is Add a New Sheet. And then I've defined sheet name to create as a string. SH as a workbook, NSH as a new workbook, nrange as a range, cont as a worksheet, and oRng as a range, which stands for original range. So let's see what else we've done here now. So I have set the name to create as the active cell. So it's the cell that you're clicking on is what's the new sheet's going to be called. And so then I'm setting the original range to the active cell so that we need to know what the original cell was. And SH equals sheets equals one is my first sheet is sheet one. Now what I'm doing is I am going to test to see whether that worksheet exists. And so from worksheet one to worksheets count, so it counts how many worksheets we have. And I'm going in lowercase just to make sure I didn't do a typing error. And so it's lowercase and uppercase, so sometimes I do all lowercase or the other. So I'm checking each of these sheets to make sure that they're not the sheet name to create. And then if it is, then I'm going to have a message box come up and say this sheet already exists. And then I'm going to, if that's true, then I'm going to exit sub. And now I'm going to keep going, and so this is a loop, it's a for loop, and so I have next, so I'm going to keep going through my my sheets to make sure they're not there yet. And so my sheets that have my marks on it is called sheets mark breakdown, and I'm getting it to be visible. And then I'm going to take this sheet mark breakdown and copy it. And then I'm putting it in the last sheet, so it's counting how many sheets I have in my workbook, and it's putting it after the last sheet. Active window, active sheet name. So now I need to change the name to active sheet name, which is the cell that we had originally selected, sheet name to create. And so now I'm making sheet markdown breakdown invisible, or not visible anymore, so I'm visible equals false. And now I'm activating sheet one, and then I'm going to do add a hyperlink. So sheet one hyperlink add. Now oRng was my original range, which was the name that I want to do. And then I'm adding sheet name to create, and I'm going to A1 and go to, and then sheet name to create and sheet name to create. Now I'm setting the original range to nothing, and I'm ending sub. So let's go back and let's put in on sheet one, let's put in, Brenda Brown. So I have tied my macro to the add button here. So you right click on this and you get assign macro, and then I've assigned it to my macro name. So now when I click on the Brenda Brown and I click on Add, we now have Brenda Brown and it's linked to the name and the sheet are linked together. That's how you link and add sheets. Please subscribe.